Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's VENM Fire here, back with another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys part two of my free New Orleans Saints offensive playbook. Now, obviously, if you haven't checked out part one, you're going to want to watch that one before you go ahead and watch this one. Now, if you're coming from part one, I'm going to show you guys a couple of other great formations aside from the ones I showed last video. That's going to include the Trey Y Flex, the Empty Y Sate Pinch Pistol Bunch Tight End, and we have the I-Form Close and Slot Flex. So, starting off, I'm going to be in this Trey Y Flex. Now, I have a full scheme of this on my YouTube channel, a separate video on the Trey Y Flex alone. Make sure to go check that out for some additional tips and additional plays. I have a tip to put your receiver at tight end, so make sure to go watch that video. I'm not going to cover that in this one, and I also cover a couple of other plays that I don't in this breakdown. So, starting off, my audibles are just going to be levels Y corner, read option, SC corner, and PA crossers. I just prefer the read option. It's pretty much the same as the inside zone. I just like it a little better for whatever reason. But so starting off, I'm just going to come out in this levels Y corner and be going against a random play. I'm just going to go ahead and respot the ball here really quickly and before we get started. So here. Now, the play that we are going to be setting up is very popular among people in the Madden community. Pretty much, if you're running any formation, people know how to cover or know how to run this. People run this all the time. It's pretty much one of the most popular plays in the game, and I have a pretty simple setup. Usually, what I like to do is just simply streak slant wide, motion in the middle a little bit, hike him about there, and hit him there. Kills man coverage, and it is the perfect, very simple play, simplistic route combination, route setup, and pretty much anybody can run this and make a read. We have a high low on the right side. Just going to dump it down to Kamara here and pick up some easy yardage. Gain about 5-6 there. And it is a very just simple play to make a read. If he's covering down low too much, you have that B route. If he's playing man, you just hit this Y route super fast. And here, as you guys see, he's killing the man again. We end up picking some huge yardage just off a simple slant play, which you can with any of these plays here. This Trey White Flex, very simple scheme, and it's going to be pretty easy to make reads here. I get B open, I'm just going to lowball that. As you see, we hit that dot, so just have to make your read, and pretty. You can even run it stock if you want. Here you guys see, I see that Cloud Flat's just going to go ahead and end up covering the tight end late. I can hit Kamara even after his route is concluded. And it's just a very simple read to make. Very simple play combination. So the X route is on the left is really just if you have nothing. So you can just dump it down late if you're rolling to the right and you haven't come across. Here we get a complete man coverage look. So I'll just show the setup one time. If it's complete man coverage, you might just block your running back, do something like this. Motion, hike, hit him. As you guys see, if I would have blocked my running back, I would have had Y wide open, but I didn't, so yeah. Anyway, that's going to bring us to our next play, the Gun Trey Y Flex. It's going to be this read option now, or inside zone. This is probably the most popular, one of the most popular inside zones in the entire game. It is, the blocks just set up very well in this, and I do show the perfect blocking adjustments on that full setup, so make sure that you guys do check that out. I have tons of these separate formations with full, even more in-depth breakdowns. So what I do is just motion this Y guy in, hike him about on the left tackle's hip, and you guys see, look at that blocking. I was so many yards before I even got contacted by a defender. You can even run it. You can run it stock if you want, something like this, but I don't know. I seem to have more success just motioning that slot wide receiver in. As you guys see, I would motion this B receiver in, but I can't hike the ball. I'm clicking A, and you can't hike him until there. Even though that was a pass play, it didn't matter. If that was a run play, I still wouldn't have been able to hike him. So just motion this Y guy in. Sometimes there won't be anybody even motioning with him. Hike him about there and go to work. Here we get a almost perfect blocking, and we can end up taking this to the house. I'm just gonna fall down, save some time on the video. Don't want no point to go to the end zone there. So again, I'll just show you. Oh shoot, actually I just audibled to the incorrect formation, my bad on that. But pretty much it's just a simple run. You can spam this. If your opponent can't stop it, why would you stop running it? Just come out. He can't stop the inside zone, just keep on running it. If the ain't broke, don't fix it. Sometimes they will get that edge off the Heat, though, which is kind of frustrating, but it happens. Running the ball, you're going to get some weird things. Here's a perfect situation to where you're definitely going to motion him in. Nobody even follows him, and I can take this to the outside with some easy run stick and pretty much take that to the crib. And yeah, it's probably going to do it for my read option. I'm just going to show you guys one last time here. Motion him in, hike him about there. And that's an easy gain of yardage before I even get contacted by the defender. That's going to take us to our third play out of this formation. It's going to be this SE corner. It's pretty much a very similar play to the levels Y corner. We just have that tight end and that B receiver on a different route. So what I like to do is just streak Y. That B route is not going to kill man coverage, something to be pointed out, but it will beat zone. Beat a lot of zones, which is nice. You can motion this X guy in a little bit, hike him about there. And here I'm just gonna hit Kamara out of the backfield. Pick up your easy yards, like I said in my previous video. Just take the flats. I know it's not the flashy play, it's not the one play touchdown, it's not the one play bomb, but taking your flats is gonna allow for those. Your opponent's gonna be guarding down and you're gonna be able to hit it. There you see we hit that A route. Although it is a slow developing route, it can get open late in plays. If your opponent ends up coming back to the in route, you can end up getting wide open. So again, here, just simple setup. Here, B's not open, so I'm just going to hit X on this. End up getting a block from that wide receiver, and we're able to get it for an additional couple yardage. So again, here, just this, oh shoot, wrong play. Again, here, just a simple setup. You can even leave that X guy out wide if you want. Here I'm going to hit B. It actually does kill man coverage, but something to be noted was that Michael Thomas on Tremaine Edmonds. He's going to win that matchup 100 out of 100 times. So just very simple reads. Again, it's man coverage, but I can just hit that X receiver even though it was man on an in route. You can also put him on a slant if you want, if he's running strictly man coverage. Let's say you have any hot route specialist on that B receiver, you're gonna put him on that quick corner. So if I do, I'm just gonna show an example here. I'll put him on that corner. It's a lot faster and it can kill man coverage. So I'm just gonna hike it and lowball that X route there because they were covering over the top. I had to make a quick read, otherwise I would have been boxed. So that's a very good thing to do if you're just any low ball on an in route or a drag route, something. I can get on a drag route here, and I'm just gonna motion snap hike him there like that, and we pick up an easy 7 yards. So you don't have to worry about making a read. Usually it's gonna be open, your opponent's not gonna be playing that down far unless you do it a couple times in the game. So I'll show you guys a setup one last time here. Here it is again, looking, A's gonna get wide open here. That route just takes a little bit too long to develop. We also had the corner route as well. So yeah, that's going to take us to our last play of our gun tray Y flex. It's going to be this PA crossers. Now, everybody knows PA crossers. They all have their personal preferences on setup. So I'm just going to show you guys my basic setup, and then I'm going to show you guys a way to beat man coverage. So my basic setup is just going to be fade A, drag Y, put X on an in route, and smart out that in route. So here it is, the full setup. We have that drag, two crosser high low read, and if we have nothing open, let's say he's playing hard flats and he's using the crosser, we can hit that deep in route late. We can lowball that, do a lot of things to beat the zone coverage, the computer. So again, here you can leave that play action. I usually like it, for some reason I seem to play better with the play action. But here you see obviously that B route is gonna kill almost every zone in the game. So your opponent's pretty much gonna use him. Unfortunately, man coverage can sometimes beat it. Here we're getting a man coverage look. As you guys see, stuck like glue, but the good thing, we had X wide open. That was obviously still my zone setup. So I'm just gonna show you guys that setup one more time. Drag Y, put X on an in route, smart that in route, and fade A. So here it is. Oh, I'm in the wrong play. So here is our setup. Hike it and X wide open, boom, easy dot. Obviously those were both against man, which I kind of wanted them to be zone, but it's cool. Here I'm gonna show you guys my man coverage beater out of this play. So what I like to do is just slant X, slant Y, block my running back, and streak A. And I'm just going to motion this guy over, hike him right about at the 30-yard line, that 30 number. Hike it here, looking, B's going to get wide open. And we just pass it, that's the right, Drew Brees with the overthrow. But it's cool, that was obviously zone coverage. So apparently EA, whenever I want to run man cover, I want you to run man coverage, you run zone. And whenever I want you to run zone, you run man. But it's cool. Gonna show you guys the setup again. Put them both on slants, put A on a streak, and motion this Y receiver over. This actually looks like some sort of a man coverage, and it is. Y is gonna get wide open there. Even though he was relatively close, that was a low overall receiver still getting open on the slant. Obviously, you can have a super fast guy on the slant, which will help. And especially if they don't have any zones underneath. So I'm just going to show you guys this one more time. Here we get another, I'm in the wrong play, but I'm just going to hike it anyway. We end up getting A wide open, and that's going to conclude it for this Trey White flex. I know it was a pretty long setup, but those plays are very good, and I think they are a little bit underappreciated in the formation. So anyway, heading into the empty Y Saint, it's really a one-play breakdown. I really only like one play out of this, and it's going to be the Saints fork. But it is a excellent play to like out of it because of how good it is. And you can, what I like to do on this is just drag X. Or I usually in X, so that's going to be your running back. We have those two deep posts. That Y post is a little bit more shallow, can get open a little bit better against a cover two defense without the middle third. And we're going to leave that flat for the high low on the right side with the corner. That corner route will beat man coverage. You guys see it's a faster corner, which you can pretty much tell. So X actually got sacked there. Unfortunately, the blocks weren't holding up. I'm going to show you guys again here. Same setup. Dump it down to A, nothing open. Take your flats and end up picking up 9. Now, that corner route is a little bit shorter than something maybe you would like. It could be a little deeper, but it still does work pretty fine. Here we're going to get wide open. And you guys see it gets right over the zone, and you're able to throw that dot. It's pretty much just reading whatever zones are on the right. If not, you can obviously hit your checkdowns, whatever your route. Here we get a full-on blitz. RB is just wide open, and you can possession get that, catch that. Obviously, we're running it on the wrong side. If I wanted to fully show off this play, I would just move the ball over to the left, but or motion it over. But it's cool either way. Again here, running it. Just going to hit A really quickly. Nobody's covering him, and we can end up actually getting some good yardage out of that one. So I'm going to show you guys my setup one more time. Here, in X, hike it. And we get man coverage again. No one's covering RB, so I'm going to hit him. And just get an easy gain of yardage. It will also beat man coverage, although the CPU never really ran man. This actually kind of looks like man, so I'll just show you guys the one last time. And it is, and we barely get open. That's obviously a super, like a slow, low overall receiver with garbage route running. But it still did work with him. Alright, so the next formation that I'm going to be coming out in is going to be this pistol bunch tight end. Now, this is very popular among people in the playbook. We're just going to be going over the spot option, verticals, halfback zone, and this cross drag. There's some other plays out of here you could run if you wanted to. We got a lot of good plays out of here. But just going to go ahead and come out in the spot option real quick. Now, starting off the formation, we have this spot option. It's a pretty good play stock. The only adjustment you really have to make is just going to be streaking X, and usually I'm just going to put this A guy on an in route or a curl route or a motion in route or a hot routed in route, smart routed, but I'm just going to put him on a curl because we already have tons of routes going to that side. Here we get man. You guys see, look how fast that route was. That route kills man coverage, that super fast corner again we get. And this is definitely a good play to go to. People out of this formation are not expecting a corner route like that usually. I know for sure when I'm defending it, I'm not really expecting any type of a corner route. I'm going to show you guys again here, making the high-low read. Throw that right there, and that's perfect timing with Ted Ginn Jr. He's obviously a super fast receiver, makes the read a little bit easier on me. Here we get a man coverage look again, sort of man. It could also be a bluff blitz, so hike it, and it is a bluff. What's A wide open? Just gonna dump it down for the easy yards. Take the guaranteed yardage. Don't want to run to a predicament where I'm scrambling out with Drew Brees. So again, I'm just going to show you guys my setup. You can also put B on this zig route if you want. So again, here, hike it. B is going to get wide open. Y is wide open as well. We had both guys open. Either could have been a good gain of yardage. Just going to take Y for the guaranteed yards instead of having to make a move. So again, here, here's our setup. Don't forget to block that running back for the extra protection. B is wide open. Just going to take him there. Got a weird animation there with the pass lead. Drew Brees' pass leads are super odd in this game. Pretty sure I talked about that in my previous video as well, but it's kind of what we have to do. I'm not trying to use Teddy Bridgewater. Y is wide open. That was a terrible pass lead by me, and I threw it late, so you guys can tell it was wide open. I just made a mistake. Gonna show you guys one last time here. Just hike it and had another terrible read. So I'm on a hot streak right now. Anyway, it's gonna take us to our next play, halfback zone. Pretty simple. Flip the run to this side and hike it. Basically like a strong power situation. I don't know why it's not called strong power. It's pretty much a power run. Anyway, just flip it. This is a pretty decent run out of this formation. It's obviously not a great run in the game, but if you're in this formation, he's coming out in a spread D-line look, three down linemen. You're just going to flip this play, and you can get some good yardage. As you see here, the blocking can be suspect and can be kind of frustrating sometimes. Here, we obviously want to get to the outside, but it might not be able to. I might motion X in a little bit. Hike it, and I actually do get the edge here. Pick up some nice yardage with Kamara. So it is a decent run. Is it an every play run you can do? Would you hurry up out of it? I wouldn't say so, but in a situation like this, you can pick up yards easily. Although that was awful run stick, it's fine. We still picked up a great gain on the play. So that's pretty much it. Not too much on that play. Here we get one of my, probably the favorite play out of the formation for me. It's going to be this verticals now. So you're going to have to do something extra that you might not know how to do. You're going to have to get to the line quickly, motion this tight end out, put him on a slant, motion him back in. Because as you guys see here, he can't be on a slant. He gets a block and release cross. So we want him on that slant route for this route because we're making a high-low read between this A guy and our running back. We're leaving the running back out. He's going to go on that sort of delayed route, but it's very good man coverage. And then we also have our vertical setup in case he's coming down on that ARB. We can just throw that over the top to the B guy. Also, we can hit Y in the seam really quickly, and this X guy sometimes does get open. Motion him like this and hike it here. It's man coverage. You're just going to hit A. As you guys saw, I had RB open. Somehow, he just got a suction animation, but it is cool. I'm going to show you guys that again here. Although it does take forever for me to set up, so I might not show you guys too many times. But you're really only making one hot route, so if you're running this play, you should have enough time to make the adjustment at the line of scrimmage. You can motion hike this X guy, and you guys see he's wide open quickly. Somehow Drew Brees overthrowed it, didn't even get the inaccurate quick throw icon on my screen, but you guys saw he was open. That route got open a ton last year that I ran out of the time that I ran this playbook. So again, showing you guys, motion A out, motion back in on the slant, motion Thomas out, hike it, and Y is going to get wide open here. Actually sort of played that surprising, didn't come down on the slant like I was expecting, but we end up getting the good animation with the rack egg. So I'll show you guys one last time here my setup. Going to be trying to make the RB read here if nothing else is open. So again, put him on a slant, motion him back out. Motion Thomas out, don't block your running back. Here, RB, wide open, hit him. Also had the slant open, but you guys see Kamara somehow puts the moves on him. Broke like 20,000 tackles there. But yeah, so last play is cross drag. This play is just kind of a pain in the butt guard. You have the crossers, you have the two drags, and you have that deep end. Pretty much just, I just run a stock here. A open, also had B open. Probably should have thrown it to B for the extra rack, but it's cool either way. So again, I just run a stock, blocking my running back usually. Here we hit X on the route. It doesn't really do the best job against man coverage. If I wanted it to, I would motion A out on that slant, which obviously would kind of disguise it as verticals, which could help you in the long run, but not trying to do that for every single play here. for some reason I automatically used my safety because of that quarters formation, but it would have been open either way. So I'll just show you guys our setup one last time. Make a simple read. Here we've been playing man coverage. Here we need a zone look. Y gets open. Passley, that's the right and easy dot. Not with Drew Brees, since somehow he overthrows more than Lamar Jackson in this game, but it's cool either way. I'm going to go ahead and come out in our I-form close formation now. Alright, so now we're going to be coming out in this I-form close. Now, this is a formation that I covered fully on my YouTube channel. I have a full video on this. If you want to go check that out, it's out of the Oakland Raiders offense, though. So this is the Saints one. It's a little bit different. I already preset my audibles. We have the stretch, dive, drag wheel, and PA Saints shot. So I'm just going to come out in this halfback lead dive. You want to run it flipped like this so you can get the better handoff. With a righty quarterback, if you have a lefty, you're going to run it to this side. You can obviously flip it either way. It doesn't really matter. So what I'm going to do to get the better blocking is just come out in it like this and flip it. Now, all you have to do is flip it. You want that the run to the right, and you can just run it like this. Or I can motion B in like here. Hike it. You end up getting that weak side block and end up picking some great yardage on the play. The dive's pretty much for the spread out defenses, not really good against these congested type of defenses. Motion them in again, actually ran to the incorrect side, forgot to flip the play, but we get excellent yardage out of that run right there. And yeah, the dive is probably the best run in the game in my opinion, not this one specifically, but dive in general. It's just so OP. It's just difficult to stop how quick the handoff is and how easy it is to read the holes out of dive. Whether to cut it to the left or right, it's pretty simple. Just go away from the user. So I'm just going to show you guys one last time here. Motion, hike right there. And my fullback ran to the left at the last second there. It looked like he was going to pick up that block on the right side, but he didn't. So again here, you don't even have to motion. I can just run it like this. Some bad run stick there. Probably should have cut it to the outside, but it's not really good against these big congested formations. I'm going to show the stretch here. Stretch, I can run it like this. Usually when I'm running the stretch to the strong side, I'm just going to motion this fullback out. Hike it here. Cut it to the outside. And make a move. There's some great yardage. Stretches. Stretch and dive is probably the best run combination in the game, to be honest. Here in a situation like this, I'm running dive, but since I'm showing off the stretch, I'm just going to come out in it. You can even motion them out like this if you want to cut it inside like that. Obviously got the worst cutting animation of all time there, the one cut, but it is cool. Again, I'm gonna cut it inside here. Actually, fullback misses another block, surprise surprise, but you guys know how this game be. Obviously you might get a faster fullback than that. Here I get a perfect situation to cut it outside and pick up an easy first down right there. So next way I like to run is just flip the play. Flip the play. So I'm running the stretch to this side, motion this receiver over completely to about here and hike the ball. Kamara gets the outside and we pick up some great yardage there. Very simple run and a very simple setup. So again, I see there's not too many players on the left side of my motion getting over, and we're gonna get some great blocking here. Cut it inside and pick up some easy yardage with Kamara there. So these runs are excellent out of the formation. I love these. I love the iForm close runs this year, and so do a lot of other players. So anyway, here I'm coming out in this drag wheel. This play is great stock because look at how fast that corner route is with the tight end. It's again one of those man beating routes. You get a super good tight end and he will kill people out of this. Plus, a lot of people might not be expecting the pass out of this formation. They might be playing run. Let's say they're sending an engage 8 with man coverage. You can kill it out of this. And you're pretty much blocking a lot of players. What I'm going to do is block my fullback and put Kamara on that wheel route that we had the fullback on. Just run it like this pretty much. Looking X wide open. Just going to take that and make a move in the open field. Get a ton of yardage just on a simple drag route. Again, I'm going to show you guys the setup. So just block our fullback, put that running back on a wheel. You can even motion him out if you wanted to. Sort of set up like this. You have the slant and the drag. Just to make a little more, but then it gives away that you're passing the ball because you obviously can't run if you don't have a running back. So that's kind of setup I don't really use unless it's let's say it's a 3rd and 15. He knows I'm not running anyway. Might as well do it. wrong play. So again, here, just wheel running back, block our fullback, and come out in it. A, tried to get him open. Just going to do something here. And we get Thomas wide open. Oh, somehow I just hurdled three guys. I don't know how that happened, but that was kind of lit. Anyway, I'm going to show you guys our last set play here. PA Saints shot. This is my favorite passing play out of the formation. In a very simple setup, just put A on this in route and put Y on that out to the right. So we have reads all over the field. Hike it here, looking X wide open. That flat zone came down to cover that in that out route with the running back, and we could hit Thomas wide open. So again here, we also have six-man blocking, which is nice. Here, come on. Oh, shoot. My icon on defense was blocking that white defender, that Bills corner. So, again, here, wrong play. Here's our setup. We have this is a very good setup, probably the best setup I do out of this formation. Again, I missed the read, and I get sacked. So, it works against zone, not man coverage. The other play is definitely better against man. I'm going to try to get a zone look here, though. Hike it here, and X should get wide open on this. You see that guy came, Tre'Davious White came down a little bit, which led us wide open on the crosser. So, definitely an excellent play to run against zone. That crosser combination kills. And anyway, that's going to go ahead and take us to our last formation, which is going to be this I form slot flex. What I like to do is keep this put this dive in, put this toss in. I like the hitch corner play a lot, and you can also use this PA cross in. So I might also come out in this Saints halfback zone, and this is a very similar play to stretch. Here you guys see, just run it, and I can read the inside to the outside. You guys see I pick up some major yardage there with Kamara before even getting touched. Easy cut to the outside with my halfback. Oh, it's quarter three deep. I'm running man coverage. Run this up the gut. And even with the screen on the left side, it didn't matter. I was able to run it right down their throat. So, again, we in the Saints halfback zone, you can just run it. Cut to the outside, very simple. And pick up some great yardage. Sometimes if it's a slower play, your opponent can blow it up with his user, but it is still cool either way. Now, the next play I'm covering is this halfback toss. Now, it's kind of funny. Some of the other I-form slots, I'm not able to flip this toss, which is kind of annoying. But in this one, you are. What I like to do, motion this guy out and just run it. Read the hole. Here, we're able to cut it to the outside and make a move there. Very simple. Unfortunately, they sort of nerfed toss a little bit this year. It's super slow. The tosses are very slow. And I actually can't even motion that tight end over unless I flip the run. So, again, here, perfect blocking. I take that back. My fullback and tight end blocked absolutely nobody. But we still get a great gain even with that. So, I'm going to show you guys one last time here. Flip the run, motion this fullback out, and hike the ball. And we get perfect blocking and make that cut up the field. All right, so that's going to take us to our next one, dive alert smoke. Now, it's unfortunate that we don't have a regular dive, so we can't do that, but we can just run this dive. We're obviously never really going to throw that screen pass because it's kind of trash. Maybe if it was a bubble screen, that would be another story, but since it is a regular screen with the wide out, nothing much you can do. Here again, we just get blown up. That was a terrible run decision. Obviously, if I wasn't trying to show off the dive, I would have audibled to a toss there. Again here. Oh, I actually sort of had him open and tried to hit him there. Although the dive was pretty clamped up too. Just going to run the dive here. Again, perfect. Some great blocks there up the middle. And I can just make some great yardage out of it. That was the wrong play there. So I'll show you guys this dive one last time here. Hike it and run it up the gut. Some good yardage against if they're covering against the tosser that's that stretch, then they're not going to be able to cover the dive. So here we get one of my favorite plays out of this formation. It's going to be this hitch corner. What I like to do out of it is just streak X, drag Y for a setup like this. We get the corner with the post and the drag. Hike the ball here, looking, hit Y. That was some heavy pressure. Now, this play doesn't beat man. That should be noted. That corner is a little bit slow. It's not one of those fast-breaking routes. Anyway, just going to drag Y. You guys see the full setup. We have some nice reads, some nice plays over there. Here we actually float it up over the top and get Michael Thomas. I just kind of wanted to throw it to him because he had that double mean chemistry. But you guys see he actually got some separation. Maybe if I bolted that, it could have been a catch. Just going to show you guys one last time here. It does beat zone. I've been going against some man coverage though. Hike it here. A should get wide open over the middle. And it does kill the linebacker with that post route. The post route is very nice out of this play. Just kind of one of the reasons I like it. Yeah, and if you want to run it stock, you can. Just low ball that hitch. Easy getting yardage. It's going to take us to our last play, this PA cross in. I don't really run this play too much, to be honest. I'm just going to show you guys this last play here. We kind of want four plays out on the field. What I like to run out of it is just going to be drag this X receiver, and I'm just going to put this running back on this out route so I can in that X receiver. Run it like this. Come out. Low ball that B route, and we actually get it open. Sort of a nice corner crosser, even though we got bumped. I don't really run this play too much, as you guys might be able to tell by my audibles. It's a pretty odd setup, but again, here, heavy pressure, and we throw a pick, so yeah. We actually end up almost throwing a pick six there, but it is cool. I don't really run this play. I only have those three plays that I like to run, really. Those four plays, actually. But I'm just going to run the ball here, pick up some easy yardage. So that is probably going to go ahead and conclude my video for today. Make sure that if you did enjoy the video and the free ebook, make sure to leave a like on the button. Show your support to the channel. Make sure that if you are not subscribed, to subscribe to the channel for some more Fire Madden 20 tips and tricks. Make sure to turn on your post notifications to be notified every single time I upload. And go check out some of my other videos. I have some bangers on the channel, some great formation breakdowns, other ebooks, blitzes, play breakdowns, anything you can think of. It's right here. So yeah.